Oi, tudo bem com você? Muito bem-vindo, muito bem-vinda à nossa última aula nesse curso de português de sobrevivência. Eu sou o Eli, seu professor de português. Welcome. This is our last lesson in the Survival Brazilian Portuguese course, a Brazilian Portuguese course for beginners. If you're traveling to Brazil or if you're coming here for the first time or if you have Brazilian friends and you want to get started talking with your friends in Brazilian Portuguese, this is the course for you. This is the last lesson. It means that we're going to say goodbye to each other, and that's exactly what we'll learn after watch this 13th lesson. But don't forget, this course has a learning guide. It includes extra vocabulary, expressions, and exercises to help you stick those words, to help those words stick to your memory. And you will also be able to download the Brazilian Portuguese Student Starter Kit with a Brazilian Portuguese pronunciation course, a guide explaining all the verb tenses that we have in Brazilian Portuguese, the verbs that are most common, and also a cheat sheet so that you can print it out and have it by your side next time you study Portuguese. And as always, we're going to have the lesson goals first, os objetivos da aula. E estes são os objetivos. These are the goals. Estes são os objetivos. Aprender diferentes formas de se despedir em português. Learn different forms of saying goodbye in Portuguese. Despedir-se, to bid farewell. Praticar expressões de gratidão para diversas situações. Practice gratitude expressions for the several situations. Entender o uso apropriado de despedidas formais e informais. Understand the appropriate use of farewells, goodbyes that are formal and informal. And I find it so easy in French. I remember that, like prendre congé. But it's not a French class, it's English and Portuguese. And these are the most informal ways to say goodbye, as despedidas informais. You know, you remember, twice, pause, say it aloud. I won't even complete, because for those who understand it well, only half a sentence is necessary, as we say in Portuguese. Para bom entendedor, meia palavra basta. Let's go. Vamos lá. Tchau. Tchau. Até logo. Até logo. Até mais. Até mais. A gente se vê. I really like this one. A gente se vê. Falou. Falou. Of those, I tend to use all of them. When I say até mais, it sounds a little bit more friendly, but not as informal. That's the only one, and this is a personal sensation. A gente se vê, I actually used this expression this morning when I was talking to a student, and falou is something that I use with my friends. Ah, falou, tchau. I even repeat, falou, meaning bye. More formal ways to say goodbye. The first one, adeus. Adeus. Até a próxima. Até a próxima. Foi um prazer. Foi um prazer. Tenha um bom dia. Tenha um bom dia. Boa viagem. Boa viagem. And here there is one that's very interesting. Tenha um bom dia. That sounds formal to the point that it is cold sometimes, depending on how you say it, of course. If you're angry, tenha um bom dia. It's like, I like a bad word. But tenha um bom dia, that's more friendly, huh? Or friendlier. You can also say, tenha uma boa tarde, ou tenha uma boa noite. Ou, with other times, for example, tenha um bom fim de semana. Have a good weekend. Tenha um bom fim de semana. And you can also combine and match a few of those. Até a próxima. Foi um prazer. Até a próxima. Foi um prazer. Ah, foi um prazer. Tenha um bom dia. You can mix and match a few of them. And expressions of gratitude. The first one is the most common one. Obrigado. Obrigado. Or, obrigada, as a woman. Obrigada. And quick thing, it comes from an expression, an old expression, that's the explanation we got when we were kids, that obrigado, it means I am obliged. I am obligated to return the favor, so thank you. Obrigado. It's just to state that, yes, in the future I'm going to return the favor. But nowadays, it's just thank you. Obrigado. Obrigada. Muito obrigado. Muito obrigado. Muito obrigada. Muito obrigada. Agradeço. Agradeço. Valeu. Valeu. Ah, você é muito gentil. Você é muito gentil. Obrigado. And here I mixed formal and informal expressions as well. Obrigado and muito obrigado are neutral. You can use them in every situation. Valeu is something that you would use with your friends if you're working for a Brazilian company, and then after you finish the meeting you say, valeu, pessoal. It sounds like, what? But valeu is very informal. Literally, it means it was worth it. And many young people tend to pair valeu with falou up. So they would say, valeu, falou. Meaning, thank you, bye. Valeu, falou. Agradeço is something that I use a lot. It's kind of formal, but it's also, it allows for more room for other expressions. Because you can thank something, you can thank someone for something specifically. For example, agradeço a ajuda, thank you, for your help. For is understood. Agradeço o papo, thank you for the chat. Agradeço a visita, thank you for the visit. And você é muito gentil. Sometimes it's a way to say thank you. When you say, oh, you really didn't need to. Ah, você é muito gentil. Obrigado. So, formal, agradeço. Você é muito gentil, kind of. Neutral, ou neutras. Obrigado, muito obrigado. Informal, valeu. And replying and responding to that, thank you. And before we do that, just wait a second. Gosh, cold. Obrigado, obrigado. Okay, so, and here's how you would respond. We have a few that are formal, and a few that are informal, and a few that are neutral. De nada. De nada. Não há de quê. Não há de quê. Ah, não há de quê. O prazer é meu. O prazer é meu. As suas ordens. As suas ordens. Disponha. Like tipping an imaginary hat. Disponha. And here, de nada is the most common one. Or nada. And sometimes a few friends say, imagine, like, imagina, meaning don't mention it. But it's not here. Não há de quê is very formal. Ah, não há de quê. O prazer é meu. It's like, thank you. Like, the pleasure is mine. And just one quick thing. Sometimes we meet some people that we don't really like. And then we can say also, ah, it was a pleasure. Foi prazer. And then you can say, the pleasure is all yours. O prazer é todo seu. It's not mine. But it's just a joke. Ok. As suas ordens, it's very formal and it really, it's formal because it creates a hierarchy. And it means like that you're lower in that hierarchy and the other person is higher. And then this relationship is very respectful. As suas ordens. And disponha. It's a short one. Usually I see that in writing. In speaking, we say that too, but not so often. We just say, oh, de nada, disponha. And disponha actually means dispose, meaning dispose of my help. You can use it. And prática guiada. Here is a farewell dialogue between Ana and João. Ana says, João, muito obrigada por toda a sua ajuda durante minha visita ao Brasil. João, thank you very much for all your help during my visit or stay in Brazil. Que isso, Ana? O prazer foi todo meu. Espero que tenha gostado da sua estadia. Ah, don't mention it, Ana. Que isso is actually a way to contradict someone. Que isso, não, não, nada. O prazer foi todo meu. The pleasure was all mine. Espero que tenha gostado da sua estadia. I hope you have liked your stay. Oh, I hope you liked your stay. Adorei. Aprendi tanto sobre a cultura brasileira. Sou muito grata pela sua hospitalidade. Adorei. I loved it. Aprendi tanto sobre a cultura brasileira. I learned so much about Brazilian culture. Sou muito grata pela sua hospitalidade. I am very grateful for your hospitality. Fico feliz em ouvir isso. Você é sempre bem-vinda para voltar. I'm happy to hear that. I'm glad to hear that. You're always welcome to come back. Obrigada. Bom, acho que está na hora de ir para o aeroporto. Thank you. Well, I think it's time to go to the airport. Acho que está na hora. I think it's time. Acho que está na hora de ir. I think it's time to go. Acho que está na hora de ir para o aeroporto. Tudo bem. Quer que eu chame táxi para você? Okay, all right. Do you want me to call a taxi for you? Quer que eu chame táxi para você? Não precisa. Já pedi Uber. Mas agradeço a oferta. You don't need to, or it doesn't need. I already ordered an Uber. But I thank you for the offer. Mas agradeço a oferta. De nada. Boa viagem de volta. A gente se vê na próxima vez que você visitar o Brasil. Ah, you're welcome. Good trip back to your place. We see each other next time you visit Brazil. Com certeza. Até a próxima, João. Tchau. Sure. See you next time, João. Bye. Tchau, Ana. Se cuida. Bye, Ana. Take care. Se cuida. And one quick thing. Sometimes we say, a gente se vê. This sentence that we have here. A gente se vê. Quite over here. A gente se vê. And although it translates as, we see each other, it doesn't really mean that we want to see each other in the future. It's just a polite way to say, or a nice way to say, yeah, bye. I hope we see each other in the future. It's like a hope, not really a certainty. Now, the dialogue again, this time without translations. João, muito obrigada por toda a sua ajuda durante minha visita ao Brasil. Que isso, Ana? O prazer foi todo meu. Espero que tenha gostado da sua estadia. Adorei. Aprendi tanto sobre a cultura brasileira. Sou muito grata pela sua hospitalidade. Fico feliz em ouvir isso. Você é sempre bem-vinda para voltar. Obrigada. Bom, acho que está na hora de ir para o aeroporto. Tudo bem. Quer que eu chame táxi para você? Não precisa. Já pedi Uber. Mas agradeço a oferta. De nada. Boa viagem de volta. A gente se vê na próxima vez que você visitar o Brasil. Com certeza. Até a próxima, João. Tchau. Tchau, Ana. Se cuida. And you can take this se cuida because it's really good. And bam. Production. Homework. Remember, you don't really need to write a dialogue or complete paragraph. If you can do so, that's great. Do it. But if you cannot do so, don't feel bad about that. You are learning. So the good thing here is that you can retrieve the words and information related to those situations as fast as you can. So write sentences, key phrases, key sentences that you can remember related to the following situations because you are about to finish your trip in Brazil and you need... Você está terminando sua viagem ao Brasil e precisa... Thank your host for the hospitality. Agradecer seu anfitrião pela hospitalidade. Say goodbye to a new friend, promising to keep in touch. Despedir-se de um novo amigo, prometendo manter contato. Dizer adeus a um grupo de colegas de trabalho de maneira formal. Say farewell to a group of co-workers in a formal manner. And the last one is deliberate. Adeus. Because you will not see them probably and you will not work in that company anymore. So you say adeus. Você diz adeus. And cultural tip. No Brasil, as despedidas são geralmente calorosas e podem levar algum tempo. É comum as pessoas continuarem conversando mesmo depois de dizerem tchau. Além disso, abraços e beijos no rosto, um ou dois, dependendo da região, são formas comuns de se despedir, mesmo em situações não tão informais. We have some facts here. No Brasil, as despedidas geralmente são calorosas. In Brazil, the farewell, the goodbyes are generally warm, calorosas, e podem levar algum tempo. And they can take some time. And that's true. I hate saying goodbye, by the way, because even in the classes, I have to say goodbye because like I work on a schedule and I have to check the next student that I have, like the schedule. And sometimes I say goodbye, but I am very Brazilian, so I keep talking and the student keeps talking and then we say, oh my God, the time's passed. And then it's really, really common. So, elas podem levar algum tempo. É comum as pessoas continuarem conversando mesmo depois de dizerem tchau. It's common for people to continue talking or to keep talking even after saying goodbye, tchau. This is really true. And by the way, this is something that Brazilians sometimes find rude, but it's just a cultural difference. I have a few friends from other countries where they're more kind of straightforward, to the point. And when they say goodbye, they hang up. And then we are like, what? What did I do? Why did they hang up so fast? They just said bye, bah! No, we say bye, bye, see each other, say goodbye, say hello, send your friends my regards, tell them that I miss them, and we keep talking. That's usually what we do. Além disso, abraços e beijos no rosto. In addition to that, hugs and kisses on the face, like cheeks here. Um ou dois, dependendo da região. One or two, depending on the region. In Brazil, são formas comuns de se despedir. Or common ways to say goodbye. Mesmo em situações não tão informais. Even in situations not so informal. Or not so informal situations. That's very true. When I was younger, I was kind of I don't like to say that, but it's like I lived in a cave because I didn't see as many people as I wanted to see because I lived in a very small town, in a very small place as well. And I learned to say, to offer a hand for a handshake. And when I came to Salvador, when I was younger, I remember people were like, oh, I want to hug you. And then, and I was like, I was always... flabbergasted, I think that would be the word, because people wanted to hug and kiss, and I was like, I don't know you. But that's very common and very regular, and usually that's what I do nowadays. But remember, if you don't feel comfortable with that,
offer a hand. A handshake never hurts anyone. Unless you have a knife, but that's something else. Recap.
Nós aprendemos diferentes formas de se despedir em português.
We learn different ways to say goodbye in Portuguese.
Praticamos expressões de gratidão para diversas situações.
We practiced gratitude expressions or expressions of gratitude for several situations.
And we understood, nós entendemos o uso apropriado de despedidas formais e informais.
We understood the appropriate use of formal and informal ways to say goodbye.
And, well, I hate to say goodbye, and I'm not going to keep you here for a long time. Not if it's not a call, but you know, parabéns, congratulations, you've finished the course.
I have to say, not everyone goes through 13 lessons like this, and they study regularly, and they check everything. So you are in a very exclusive group of people who actually do something with the knowledge that is offered to them.
Remember, practice regularly. If you can do like 10, 20 minutes a day, it's much better than once a week for 2 hours. Because you want to keep warming up the knowledge in your head so that it gets cooked. If you do it only once a week and then you don't do anything else for 7, 8, 10 days, the knowledge is going to get rotten and disappear. Or decay, as we say.
Não tenha medo de usar o que aprendeu em situações reais.
Don't be afraid. I know it's easier said than done. I have had my share of stuttering, talking with people in different languages. I remember one very painful experience learning Polish when I talked to a teacher and I had so many things in my head that I wanted to tell her, in Polish, of course. And the only thing that I could say was nierozumie. Nierozumien. I don't understand. And kind of painful, but I understand.
We have to practice.
Nowadays, I can speak some more, but at the time, terrible. And good luck in your next trip in Brazil.
Boa sorte na sua próxima viagem ao Brasil.
If you come to Salvador and you want to meet up, let me know. If I am not teaching on that day, I might even show up to scare you.
It's another thing that we say in Portuguese. It's like, I'm gonna go visit you and scare your house. I scare the people in your house and I charge 100 bucks for that.
Eu cobro 100 reais para espantar, para assustar as pessoas na sua casa. But that's something else.
And as I said again, muito obrigado as a man, muito obrigada as a woman.
And that's for you to remember.
Por participar deste curso.
Thank you very much for joining me in this course. It's been a great ride. And remember, if you want to have lessons or you want to know the next steps, you can visit this link that is here on the screen or in the lesson description below, and we get to meet.
Muito obrigado por estar aqui. Agradeço muitíssimo a presença e parabéns por completar o curso. Tchau!
Vou fechar aqui.